For us, so in particular, the client model is connects some of predictive clients. Here's one key thing. What about if I look at the Taurus mixing that with the projective plane? Thus, it's another comp. So we know we take connect some of the, we know if we take Tauri, connect some with lots of Tauri, we get the word that Nikolai showed us at the beginning. We know if we take the projective plane, lots of them, we get the word that the surface that Andre showed us. We know if we take something with a sphere, we don't do anything. But now let's look at what happens when we take something with projective planes. Okay. So torus and projective plane, and let's look at the Klein model. Are these, do we know at the moment if these two things are going to be different or the same? You know that they're going to be different?
They should be different.
They should be different. Okay, so let's write this down so I can we can have it on camera, right? So
because Taurus is not a
claim from the class. Let me write this. Sorry, I'm relieved of all blame. Frame from the class. These are different. Okay, that's good. So that's
требование. Claim. Требование.
Oh, claim.
Okay.
Claim, speculation. Okay, so let's see if this is true. Well, this would be an activity. So, maybe I can make this. We can do this together. I'd like you guys to. Write a gluing diagram. What is a gluing diagram for? Connect some of P, K, and P. Would anyone like to do this for me? Dari, would you like to have a go? Timon?
Надо написать слово для К, и потом к нему приписать слово для П.
Could you draw the gluing diagram for us?
Нарисуй шестиугольник.
Are we sure that's the... Did anyone do it? Nikolai, did you draw it?
Yeah, I imagine.
Let
me just check.
Yes, it's true because projective plane is like C and...
Yes.
No,
well, yes, that's
not.
Right.
And the plane model is ABB.
So if we look at...
Imagine the edge...
Where is C? So, I think, oh, here we are.
Yeah, that's it.
So here is our climb bottle. Oh, okay, so you use this diagram for the climb bottle. Okay. Okay, let's keep that, and we might modify that in a moment. Now let's look at the connect sum of a torus with a projective plane. Okay, and let's see if this is the same as that. Okay?
Connect sum of the torus and project point is AB, A
yes.
Inverse B, and CC.
Okay, so it's going to be the case, I think, that to see that they're different or the same, we'll need to draw them. Okay, so Nikolai, would you like to draw?
Okay. And,
careful, just have a look. A, B,
this is
B from this.
Да, там
Б
должно быть, и не туда.
Б должно быть напротив Б.
Just have a look at the edge. Front line A, B, A inverse.
Правая.
Да, они в разные стороны смотрят.
Yeah. So Nikolai cut out this from the torus and glued on a bridge to plane.
It's plane bottom.
I'm sorry? Oh, okay, it's easy to make mistakes when on the board. I do it all the time, so. Okay, so that's taking some the torus of the projective plane. Alright, so now I'm going to make your head spin a little bit. My claim is that this surface is the same as the surface. Okay? And so this is going to be, we're going to work this out together. The first step will be, I'd like us to, firstly, forget that the letters, because it's not necessarily going to be the case that this A is going to match up with this A. But what I'd like you to do, my claim is that these are the same. Okay, so our goal today is to see that these two are the same. Okay, so maybe I'll give you an alternative picture of that one. But for this one, firstly, what I'd like you to do, see this, is I'd like you to, step one, is I'd like you to cut along here. I'd like you to cut along here so that you can glue the C's together. Okay, so let me write that down. So, step one. So cut along the line, glue the C. Okay, so in your books, I'd like you to cut here and just glue this to this. What more do you get? Please, we should be drawing. First result?
Okay. It's stopped.
No, I'd like you to take this and glue this to this.
What?
Okay.
Тебе нужно нарисовать новую картинку, Коль. Рядом, вот здесь, на этом месте, надо нарисовать новую картинку. Что получается после прыжка? Коль, обозначь разрез буквы Е, после этого нарисуй две картинки, сначала что это рядом, потом приклеенным, и после этого... Требуется нарисовать сначала одну штуку, чуть-чуть поодаль другую, этот разрез. Важно, куда направлена стрелочка. Теперь рисую то, что получается при приклеивании, когда верхняя часть остается на месте, а к ней приклеивается по букве С. То есть надо сначала нарисовать верхнюю часть.
And just remember, Nicola, when you're doing this, one way to help you remember is to think, so we were gluing the C's, so when we're going around here, so the question is, what does this part look like? Okay. So what you can think of is, this point is going to be here, and as we go along, we know we've got E, A in this, B in this.
Mm-hmm.
So if you can think of the word, just E, A inverse, B inverse, then you know E, A inverse, B inverse.
Mm.
You can help a little bit. Excellent. I understand what you're thinking. Good. Okay, so far we've got. Okay, can you guys read off the word a word for me?
A, B, E inverse. Let's see. B, A, E inverse.
Okay. Alright, so far we've got this. Now, here is going to be. So, the goal is to reach the climb bottle and a predictor plane. So, predictor plane. So, that's the predictor plane. It's another picture of the predictor plane. Another climb bottle picks on the predictor plane. So here's my climb bottle. Okay, so now here's an activity for you. It's to try and make this look like this. And here's a hint. I'd like you to cut out a triangle.
One second. Все понимают правую, что это бутылка Кленина с противной плоскостью или нет?
Cut out a triangle somewhere. I'm not sure how long it's taking, but all I can do is cut out a triangle by this. I mean something like this, or something like this, or something like this.
What means
re-glue? So that you get something like this.
Yeah.
My claim is that by removing the triangle and re-gluing it, you'll be able to get something like this. And the goal is, notice that this diagram doesn't have any two adjacent sides, K, like KK. This one doesn't have an AA or BB or anything like that. You see that?
Yeah.
So what I'd like you to do is rearrange this diagram so that by cutting out a triangle and re-gluing, so that you have a pair of edges like this. Okay, it's kind of a puzzle. Okay. So the goal is to get. Is to get a solid.
Goal, cell.
How can you do that so that you get a side, two sides that are adjacent, going in the same direction? Would you like to show us? So you cut out a triangle and you ended up with the right hand side?
So the example that is shown on the board.
Yeah.
So the line is shown.
Yeah. You cut this out and re-glue to get there? Please show us. I just guessed, I couldn't hear the same.
Wait a second, just let me draw it in my.
Please.
In my notebook to ensure that.
I cut it on.
Yes, please draw it for us. So you got a DD?
I just broke.
Yeah, so you did it?
Yeah.
So I think we have to glue this, so these two sides.
Mm-hmm.
So I think if we turn it, so this orange instead of this point, so we can see that it is the same.
Excellent. And Olian, could you write us, what is the word for that surface? The word? Word.
Слово.
Слово.
I wasn't at the last lesson.
So what we do is just pick any point and just read it off as he goes. And so at E, you say, at E, and then D is going the opposite direction, so you write D but with a bar above it. So I'll E, E, and then D bar, and then D bar. Okay, and could you write the word for this one?
Конечно.
Начинай вот там, где между L и M.
Да. После M.
Да, да. Как, а? M.
Oh, I mean it to be an L, but that doesn't matter.
So,
can we say that those
same.
Two words are the same?
So, yes, okay, the same as.
You
can speak with this word. It's E D D A A E bar A. And they.
They're the same when you replace the letters. Excellent. Okay. Good. All right. So we're seeing that the Torah. Thank you. Excellent. So we're seeing that the Torah. Thank you. Torus for the predictive plane is the same as the Quine-Gödel predictive plane, so we disprove the initial conjecture. Okay? Interesting, so that's.
Привет, в частности, это означает, что сумма – это не групповая операция. В группах так не бывает. Это называется моноид. То есть сложение есть. А аксиома группы насчет существования обратного элемента не выполнена. Обратного элемента нет.
That's in summary. Now, we know also that the Quine-Gödel, that's the same as a two-predictor plane, the some two-predictor planes. Right? So we know that torus for the predictor plane is the same as predictor plane, free predictor plane.
Вот именно. Это не является частью группы. Нельзя сократить P.
Here's just a minor question for you to think about. If the surface is can be written as something with a projective plane. Something with a projective plane, what can we say about it? If the surface B. If we know that B can be written as a something with a projective, the kinks on a projective plane. Can we speculate? Let's speculate as to what the, how can we write B? For example, if A is a Quine-Gödel, A is a Quine-Gödel, then we know that we can write it as a kinks on with three projective planes. If A is a torus, then we know that we can write it as a kinks on with projective planes. If A is a sphere, it's a projective plane. If it's a projective plane, it connects some projective plane. So would anyone like to conjecture as to what it must look like?
B is a sum of n projective planes.
Or some sum, then B is some sum of projective planes.
Yeah.
So that's the, so this is kind of the, this is the claim. And that's what we'll look at proving this.
Любая штука, которая, ну если какая-то плоскость B представима в виде A плюс проективная плоскость, то она представляется в виде скольких-то проективных плоскостей.
And part, so this is part one of our part one. Two. What if it's impossible to write B as a connect sum with a predictive plane? What if B cannot? What about if we can't write it as a connect sum with a predictive plane? What could B be then? For example,
could be a sphere.
It could be a sphere. Could it be a Quine-Gödel?
No.
Could it be a predictive plane?
No. No.
A Knick sum of predictive planes?
No.
Could it be a Knick sum of... could it be a torus?
No.
Why not?
Well, because
obviously, so if it cannot be,
has a gen,
it could be a torus, it could be a sphere.
Or it could be a sphere with handles.
The sphere with handles is a number of torus. So it could be sphere, and we could connect some tori. Now, when we connect some spheres, we don't change anything. Is that, remember that?
Yes.
And it's make a note. We could think of the sphere as zero number of tori. So if we write B must be the Knick sum of tori.
This means
tori. Where, let's say n tori, where if n is zero, we understand that the Knick sum of zero tori is a sphere.
This means that each surface can be presented as the Knick sum of either several projective planes or tori.
Right, so that's our claim that we reach, is that this is called the classification of surfaces, or part of the classification of surfaces, that a surface is either a Knick sum of projective planes or it's a Knick sum of tori. Okay? So let's finish today by looking at how to prove this.